The easiest way to explain this to you is that before we used to draw lines on paper. Then we went to drawing lines in a computer. Now we actually put the information on products into the computer so that at the end of the day, when we have a 3D model, it represents not only the physical structure, but all the intelligence about the component parts that go into that structure.
There's really two parts to the BIM process. One is the construction of a virtual or digital model. The second half of the BIM process is the addition or loading of information into the model.
BIM is a three-dimensional computer model, but it has massive amounts of intelligence in it. Every single piece of furniture, every single structure, everything in the building has intelligence to it that then can be used by other disciplines.
Really, most people refer to it as four dimensions, and the fourth dimension being something beyond spatial. And that could be time, it could be materials, it could be construction sequencing.
You can integrate the data of how long something should last, and then the owner can access that data and make sure that they do those maintenance tasks to keep the equipment in tip-top shape.
A client or a facility manager is going to have a 3D model that they can use long after the construction process is completed. They'll always have kind of a living, breathing model of their building that can be adapted as their building adapts in the real world as well.
It's all about closer interaction with the client. Really, what BIM is allowing us to do is see the end product in real time, real scale, using real accurate information.